We're here at the United States Dance Sport Championships 2019. Ballroom Backstage is taking you in deep to meet some of the competitors. And we're here with Scott Magnesen, one of the gentlemen competitors. And Scott, you have a whole list of wins to your credit, not to mention quite a resume of wins to your credit from times past.
Thank you.
Tell me, first off, just to get right down to the nitty-gritty, why ballroom dancing?
Actually, my wife and I, we've been married 37 years. And
way to go.
Yeah.
Way to go.
So,
all right.
And when our last child moved away and we have four grandchildren now, we thought we needed to do something together.
So right.
I was a golfer. She played tennis. And we had nothing we really did together. So we needed to reconnect. And so she was a dancer when she was younger. And she started out dancing. I watched her compete. And I said, you know what? I can do this too. So, and now we've been doing it about 8 years. And it's really become our passion now. So I still have a full-time job, but we actually commute from Chicago to L.A. to train with our partners, so we're pretty committed.
No kidding.
Yeah.
So you're commuting 2,000 miles. You're on Route 66.
Right. Yes, we're executive platinum on all the airlines by June. So
the airlines absolutely love them, right?
Correct. Exactly.
So, okay, well, you did it to reconnect.
Yes.
Tell me about the reconnection.
Well, we started out just doing it for social reasons. So when we go out, we would dance. Instead of going to a dinner and a movie where you just sit, we would go to dinner and then go dancing. And so, number one, it was for fitness, it was great. I mean, you put me on a treadmill for an hour, it's just awful. But I can dance for 8 hours with my partners, and it goes by like that. So we both lost weight. We both felt stronger. We had more energy. So we started out more for fitness. And then as we got competitive, it became really a way to push ourselves as far as we could go. So,
cool. Excellent. Yeah. So, I mean, looking at you, you are fit. You're fit. You're handsome. You're definitely looking 20 years younger than whatever it says on your driver's license. Talk to me about what you've done fitness-wise all the way around. What's the picture look like for you?
Well, I used to be a golfer, and I would walk golfing, but that's still not the exercise. So right now, I train about every other weekend. Usually Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, I go 8 hours, 8 lessons in a row for 3 days. Then I fly back to Chicago, and I train one night a week when I'm in Chicago. But then I mix that with about 4 days in the gym, because obviously when I'm lifting and I'm staying in good posture and frame, I need to be strong upper body. I had both shoulders operated on 3 years ago.
No kidding.
Yeah, so okay. I needed to get that fixed, and now that they've been fixed, I feel much stronger. But for me, I get up in the morning at 5 every day. I have tons of energy. And so I would tell you ballroom really gives me the energy boost that I need, especially even when I'm at work. So. Yeah.
Okay, now let's go a little bit farther than the standard sales pitch for ballroom. How does it make you feel? Like, what do you get out of it?
Well, I'm a performer. I was a musician when I was younger. So, and I'm also a motivational speaker, and I also manage money for Morgan Stanley. So I'm used to being in front of a group of 1,000, 2,000, 5,000 people, either playing music or speaking. And this gives me a similar adrenaline high. I mean, obviously, just my whole thing is make people happy. So, I mean, if I dance well, I really don't care how I place. I really care about how I dance, how I improve, and then watching people come up to me and say, hey, I had so much fun watching you. That's what kind of keeps me going. So.
Well, right. Your routines, you obviously having fun.
Oh, absolutely.
You're obviously enjoying yourself. What about the competition? What are the ups and downs of competition for you?
Well, I think the competition for me, if I go on vacation, I'm one of those people that fills my day anyway. I get up, work out in the gym, I go for a run, I go play golf, I go play tennis. So this is great because it fills my day on a vacation, but it gives my brain a rest. So even though my body's being stressed, my brain doesn't think about the stock market or what's going on at work. So it's a really great escape. And this dance world is actually a family. I mean, the more of these things you do, you get to know all your competitors, all of your friends. And actually, we keep in touch with many, many of our friends from other states that we see every month or every other month. It's really great because everybody's really supportive. So it's really kind of a country club for dance is what it is.
Do your friends from different cities, do they come watch you dance?
Oftentimes. And I have clients in every state in the United States. And so when I go to perform, a lot of my clients will come watch me, and they get to see a side of me that they don't normally see.
Wow.
So it's great.
Wow. How do you handle the people? What do you say if somebody comes up to you and says, oh, I could never do that?
Well, I tell them that anybody can do that, because I started out 7 years ago. I was a Sway to Let It Be guy. I had no dance ability at all. So, that's basically was me. Not even that good. So I would just tell anybody out there that first of all, it's fun, but secondly, you can do it. Especially if you get good teachers. I mean, here at USDC, we have some of the best dancers in the world, and I have some of the best to train from my studio in California. I've two owners are fabulous coaches. My two partners are fabulous. So when you have good people working with you every day and teaching you the right way, they can pretty much teach anyone. I mean, in our studio, I see beginners, and within 6 months, they're dancing properly and beautifully. So not that everybody wants to compete, but going out in the public and dancing after 6 months of doing this, you will look right. better than 99% of the people out there. And now, it's funny, because now when I go to a club, my wife and I will go to the club, and the girls are all asking me to dance, teaching them rumba, teach me cha-cha. Ah. My wife just goes, have him. I've had enough of him. But the point is it's socially really great. I mean, we go to parties, we go to weddings, and now, you know, dance becomes a major part of why we're excited to go. So
is she more excited? I mean, is she more excited about you? Is she more excited about the dancing? Is she, what's it like on this side of being a dancer?
Well, I think for me, it's great because my wife actually, she's number one in the country in rhythm 5 years in a row. And she won Latin yesterday. She's number three or four in smooth. So she's a very good dancer. And I think it's important to her that her husband understands how hard it is to get there. Because a lot of spouses, they see their wives doing well or their husband's doing well, but they're not doing it themselves. So right. when I see her and how much she's improved, I have a true appreciation for how hard it is to get to that level. So, I know for sure, we call it the Magnesen bookends. If I make the final, I'm thrilled, and I get sixth, and then she gets first, and we're on either end of the lineup. But it's for me, there's nothing more proud of a moment for me to be standing up there and then having my wife getting first place.
Okay, now I'm going to put you to work here.
Yep.
You have somebody's out there on the dance floor, and you're the seasoned competitor, and they're having a bad day. Mm-hmm. Get them through that day. They're frustrated with something. Get them through that. How do you do
it? Well, first of all, I do see that quite often. I will make a point to go to those people because I was there once, and I will go make a point to go.
So
up
it's
to
empathy.
It's
then.
Empathy, yeah, because I was there. I forgot routines, those blackout moments where you're like, oh, my goodness. See, when you're a female competitor, if you have a blackout moment, your pro is going to probably put you where you need to be.
Right.
As a male competitor, we forget.
You by yourself.
We're by ourselves, and our partners are left out to dry. So, you know, I go up to them and generally say, hey, listen, have fun, enjoy yourself, don't worry about it, because you're going to do, you know, hundreds of heats over the next month or two or three. But what ends up happening is, by like anything, the more you do it, the more comfortable you get. So I have found that some of the newer people, they just need a little pat in the back. And I know what it's like when somebody that's experienced comes to you and says, hey, I really enjoyed your dancing, or I've seen you improve so much since a year ago. So those words of encouragement really go a long way when you're a beginner.
So just adding a little bit of that, like spice in the cooking.
Exactly.
Well, Scott, you have such a tremendous resume here at 2019. Champion in the Gentleman's Latin, Gentleman's Smooth, Gentleman's Rhythm, and then you took a day off. No ballroom for
you today. No, I'm getting ready for a show, though. We're going to do a show tomorrow night. We were asked to do one, so my partner and I had to choreograph a quick show today.
So he's taking the postman's holiday. He takes a day off, he keeps working.
Keeps working, right.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much for having me.
Everybody's loving watching you.
Thank you.
Scott.